Hi guys, I'm back with another two blues songs, one by Sonny Boy Williamson too, and one by the great Robert Johnson, maybe the most famous blues song of all, CROSSROAD Blues. But first of all, I want to begin with Sonny Boy Williamson too. The reason he's called Sonny Boy Williamson too is because there was a famous Sonny Boy Williamson based in Chicago who was playing before Sonny Boy Williamson too, or Alex Miller, and he made a lot of recordings, was very successful. Alex Miller started playing in Arkansas on a radio show, and the host started billing him as Sonny Boy Williamson because of the fame of this other guy, and that's where the confusion comes in. Of course, Alex Miller eventually became even more famous than Sonny Boy Williamson one, and for most people, he is the Sonny Boy Williamson now, although it's worth not forgetting the first one as well, who was also great. Perhaps we'll look at some of his material further down the line. Sonny Boy Williamson was born in Mississippi to sharecropper parents, like so many of these Delta bluesmen, and in the 1930s, he toured around Arkansas with some famous people, or he was associating with some famous bluesmen of the time, like Elmore James and Robert Lockwood Jr., Willie Dixon, and even seems he came into contact with Robert Johnson at this time. It's reported that he, like so many of them, he would make his money however he could on playing on street corners. He was famous for his use of the harmonica, of course. He had certain gimmicks. He could play it without using his hands. Later on, he got a job in Arkansas on the radio station and provided some regular income. And when the interest in American blues exploded in Britain in the early 60s. He toured Britain too, and Eric Clapton, Robert Plant saw him at this time. Robert Plant says he even stole one of his harmonicas somehow or other, and seems that Sonny Boy got into a bit of a fracas at some point and had to leave Britain fairly quickly. However, he's another one of these bluesmen who really bridges a gap between the blues and modern rock and roll. And his later life was very successful, backing up players from the blues players from the British invasion to America. And he acknowledged that these guys played the blues very well. He was found dead in his bed in 1965, apparently dead of a heart attack. He was in his early 50s, and really at the height of his fame at that time. So, very successful blues story. So, let's bring up Eyesight to the Blind, which is one of my personal favorites by Sonny Boy Williamson. Just will take a moment here because I have to add the browser. Okay. Paste. Okay. Okay. Should be all right. Bring it down.
You've been talking about your woman. I sure wish that you could see mine. You've been talking about your woman. I sure wish that you could see mine. Every time the little girl starts to loving, she bring eyesight to the blind. A your daddy must have been a millionaire, 'cause I can tell by the way she walk. Your daddy must have been a millionaire, 'cause I can tell by the way she walk. Every time she starts to loving, to deaf and dumb begin to talk. All right. Making up a bread. Man in the next room was dying, stopped dying and held up his head. He said, "Man, ain't she pretty?" And the whole state knows she's fine. Every time she started loving, she rang eyesight to the blind. Let's go now.
Great, great song. Let's just get rid of this box. Yeah. I remember the first time I heard that, I thought, wow, what a blues track. She bring eyesight to the blind and such great harmonica playing. Let's pull up the lyrics here, because it's very memorable, actually. I'm not sure all of these lyrics were actually played in that version, but he goes through how she brings eyesight to the blind, and she makes a dumb talk, and she makes a deaf ear. So it's really kind of extended metaphor. You talk about your woman, I wish you could see mine. Yeah, you talk about your woman, I wish you could see mine. Every time she starts to loving, she brings eyesight to the blind. You know, her daddy gave her magic, I can tell by the way she walks. Her daddy gave her magic, I can tell by the way she walks. Every time she starts to shaking, the dumb begin to talk. She's got the power to heal you, never fear. She's got the power to heal you, never fear. Just the word from her lips and the deaf begin to hear. Yeah, really great, sort of over the top, very funny lyrics. So she's so great. She brings eyesight to the blind. She makes a dumb talk and she makes a deaf hear. And it's so exuberant, the beat and the rhythm. You can see it's really like it's already rock and roll. Really, it's got that exuberant beat to it, and superb harp playing by Sonny Boy. So yeah, certainly advise you to check out some more of his stuff, and you won't be disappointed. Great track, really. So now, I'd just like to move on to that great song by Robert Johnson, the great blues track by Robert Johnson, CROSSROAD Blues. It's been played a million times by so many different people, so many great rock and roll artists. People have argued about what it's about. Is it about him selling his soul at the crossroads so he can become a great blues man? That's a legend, and of course, it's kind of similar to the Faust legend, because he's if it's true, he sells his soul to the devil, but at the same time, although the devil keeps his end of the bargain and makes him a great blues man, nobody really realizes it during his life, and he takes no benefit from it. So it's like a classic Faustian sort of legend. Of course, it's not true, really. He just learned to play the guitar very well, and he played up the legend himself about the Crossroads. It's said that he made quite a racket in the early days when he was trying to play guitar. Sonhouse told him to get out. But he came back not too long after, maybe a year or so later, and Sonhouse was amazed at how his guitar playing had improved. So the legend began that maybe he'd been to the Crossroads. And of course, he played it up himself and wrote songs like this. So let's take a listen to this great, great song. Seminal for rock and roll, too. I went to the Crossroads, fell down on my knees. I went to the Crossroads, fell down on my knees. Right. At the browser again. Here we go. I hope. Paste. Okay. Song, what a great, great blues track. Yeah, Eric Clapton, this is called him the greatest blues man of all time, the greatest singer, and the greatest guitarist, and I certainly wouldn't disagree with that assessment. He was ranked number 5 in the Rolling Stone magazine 100 greatest guitarists of all time, and probably sounds about right. It's Keith Richards said that when he first heard Johnson playing, he thought there were two guitars rather than just one. What an incredible musician he is, incredible vocalist and incredible guitar player. This is his most famous and seminal song, really. It, more than any other song, this one is the one that most clearly makes a bridge between blues and rock and roll. Let's take a look at the lyrics. Yeah. Okay, here it is. I went to the crossroads, fell down on my knees. I went to the crossroads, fell down on my knees. Ask the Lord above, have mercy, say, poor Bob, if you please. Standing at the crossroad, I tried to flag a ride. Standing at the crossroad, I tried to flag a ride. Didn't nobody seem to know me. Everybody passed me by. The sun going down, boy. Dark gonna catch me here. Oh, the sun going down, boy. Dark gonna catch me here. I haven't got no loving sweet woman that love and feel my care. You can run, you can run. Tell my friend, poor Willie Brown. You can run, you can run. Tell my friend, poor Willie Brown. Lord, that I'm standing at the crossroads, babe, and I believe I'm sinking down. Oh, they give you goosebumps, really, don't they? What a great lyricist as well. This is really high poetry. And like I said, it's a seminal song between rock and roll and the blues. These themes about the devil, the crossroads, him giving his soul to the devil in exchange for the ability to play and sing superbly well, just kind of images which tap into the to Jung's archetypes, I think. The archetypes, the eternal images that everybody can understand in a society. And this Faustian image about selling the soul to the devil is just one of those images that everybody can understand. So, yeah, a wonderful song, and the most famous blues track of all time, probably. So, hope you enjoyed those two blues, one by the great Sonny Boy Williamson. Now I just say Sonny Boy Williamson because, as far as I'm concerned, he is Sonny Boy Williamson. Eyesight to the Blind, and, of course, the greatest and best-known blues track of all time, probably. Crossroad Blues by Robert Johnson. So if you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing and hit the like button. Thanks for your attention and see you next time. Thanks a lot.